Okay, so here is the new Google Calendar scheduling tool. Now, this is all as of April 2022. So let's take a tour and see what's in there. Okay, so you can set up a recurring appointment. You use this create button on the left, and you can really set aside a few times. Now, if you want to set aside some appointment times just for a limited time, just for the next week or two, then you can certainly do that. And you can also share a booking page, which is quite a simple page, but I'll show you anyway. Let's have a look. So we're going to create here. Oh, I know, I forgot to tell you. We've got to do this here. We've got to go into settings first. This button here up the top, settings. Down there, settings. And then we want to go down to appointment schedules. And you need to check this button. So we used to have appointment slots, but now we've got appointment schedules. So I've got to click on this. And that automatically saves after you have clicked on it. Okay, great. So let's go and create an appointment schedule here. And what we're going to do is I'm going to have a time to do a YouTube channel review. Okay. And I'm going to allow 30 minutes for that. And I'm going to make it available. Let me do it just on Monday mornings. I'm going to cancel this one and say unavailable all day just for this particular thing. And then Thursdays, I'll make it Thursday afternoon as well. Okay. So it's quite an easy interface to use, which is really nice. I like that. I'm going to, and if you wanted to make a second time during the day, you could certainly do that. Make it, I'll be available from 3 till 4 p.m. This is my local time. Now, how long in advance are people allowed to book times? I'm going to click on this. I could say straight away from now, or else I'll say no, it's going to be only for a period of time, for the next month, for the next 2 weeks, whatever. Okay? And then, how far in advance can they actually make this booking? So, you probably don't want to have too far in advance because you don't really know what's going to be happening in your life in 2 months' time, but you can reduce this down whatever you want. Now, how long before the appointment? I mean, are you happy for them to book an appointment 2 hours beforehand, or do you want to make it 12 hours? Once again, nice and easy to change these things, which is good. Going to next. Now, this is maybe not so good. I'm just going to change this to YouTube channel review. Booking page, photo and name. So this is really pretty ordinary, I think. This is just going to be your Google account photo and name, and that's it. So there's nothing in there that can allow you to add a website or anything like that, or a questionnaire. The location and conference, this is another problem here. Google Meet, but if you wanted to use Zoom, then what you're going to need to do is go none to be specified later. And then, what I would actually do is not even put it in the location because Google Maps tends to tends to open it up as a location itself. Well, where are we going to find Zoom, you know, when you're in Google Maps? So what I would do is actually put it in here, include your Zoom link, okay? And you can have a bit of an agenda there. We'll meet over Zoom, log in using this link, okay, and then you can get that link from your Zoom meeting. Now, you might ask some questions. Don't want to make it too hard for them, but what you can do here, ask them their first name, last name, and email address, and these are required fields. Let me just add an item here, and I could say a phone number, and I'm going to say that's required, or maybe I don't care. And then I might add another item here, which will be a custom item, which will be, you know, how long have you had your channel? Okay. And so that's just another way of really helping them to qualify themselves. And I might even include that in the description here. Here's what we're going to cover. Have YouTube Studio open so that we can have a look at your channel. And then confirmations and reminders. Which is good as well. We can have a calendar invitation, turns up in their calendar, and an email reminder as well. So I'm going to click save there. And so that's the booking page, and then people will open the booking page. And when they do that, they can see when I am available. Oh, I left Friday completely available. But remember, I made it for Mondays, 9 a.m. till 10:30 a.m. I didn't show you before, but you can change the meeting length to 30-minute appointments or to 45 or to custom time, whatever time suits you. And so people will book the time that they want to meet me, 3 p.m. They'll put in their number. That's optional. How long have you had your channel? I'm going to say 2 years. And then they book. So it's quite a nice interface. You really have to use the description to make it a little bit more interesting. But it's quite a nice interface to use. And so you can simply allow people to book a time with you using this Google Calendar appointment schedule.